Hello all of you. Today I would like to talk about different methods of gene transfer. Before that, I would like to define gene transfer. So it is defined simply as technique to efficiently and stably introduce foreign genes into the genome of target cells. In another way, you can define gene transfer as the insertion of unrelated therapeutic genetic information in the form of DNA into target cell. So gene transfer method are of two types. First one is direct or vector-less gene transfer. Second one is indirect or vector-mediated gene transfer. So in direct or vectorless gene transfer, we don't need any vector or organisms to transfer our gene of interest into the target cell. But in indirect or vector mediated gene transfer, we generally need vector or organism for inserting our gene of interest into the target cell. So agrobacterium mediated gene transfer is the most popular method of indirect vector mediated gene transfer. And about this gene transfer we will discuss in our latter part of my presentation. So first of all, I would like to talk about direct method of gene transfer. So direct method of gene transfer is also of two types. First one is physical method of gene transfer. Second one is chemical method of gene transfer. So in physical method of gene transfer, we generally use different forces to insert our gene of interest into the target cells. But in chemical method of gene transfer, we generally use different kinds of chemical to change the permeability of the cell membrane. And from that change permeability of cell membrane, we generally insert our gene of interest into the target cell. So what are the different physical method of gene transfer? So these are electroporation, particle bombardment method, micro injection, macro injection, and sonoporation. Under chemical method of gene transfer, we have these different methods, that is CSL2 mediated gene transfer, or we can say this is also known, or we can also say it as bacterial transformation. Liposome mediated gene transfer, it is also known as lipofection. DAE, diethyl aminoethyl dextran mediated gene transfer. Polyethylene glycol mediated gene transfer. So we will discuss about all these gene transfer method in detail one by one. So let's first discuss about electroporation. So electroporation is the method of gene transfer in which we generally insert our gene of interest inside the eukaryotic or prokaryotic cell by applying very high voltage, pulse across the cell membrane of prokaryotic or eukaryotic cells. So in this process, what we generally do, first we generally apply very high voltage for a short period of time, that is also known as pulse. That generally disturbs the membrane integrity, or you can say plasma membrane integrity can be disturbed by applying very high voltage for a short period of time, that is pulse, or you can say high voltage pulse. This results in the formation of pores across the plasma membrane, and from that pore the foreign DNA enters inside the cell like this. So you can easily see here that how very high, by applying high voltage pulse, we can by applying very high voltage pulse across the plasma membrane, we can insert the foreign DNA or you can say our gene of interest inside the cell. So the main advantage of this process is that it's very simple, it is very cheap, and it's highly efficient. Highly efficient means by this process you can transform or transfect more cells at one time, right? And it can be helpful in transfecting, or you can say this method can be helpful in the transfer of our gene of interest or DNA of interest into both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. So these are the main advantages of electroporation. Now the second important physical method of gene transfer is particle bombardment method, and it is also known as gene gun. So in this process, what we generally do, so it looks like this. Gene gun look like this. So in particle bombardment method, what we generally do, we first coat the gold particle with our gene of interest, and that is known as DNA coated gold particle. And this DNA coated gold particle we generally give acceleration to this DNA coated gold particle by applying the pressure through helium gas. And that accelerated DNA coated gold particle is known as microprojectile. So that microprojectile generally enters inside the cell through plasma membrane, through cell wall and plasma membrane, right? So by this way, through this gene gun method, we can insert our gene of interest in our target cell. So originally it was designed to transform the plant cell, and it is also known as ballistic particle delivery system. Why it is known as ballistic particle delivery system? It is known as ballistic particle delivery system because in this process, the gene of interest generally insert inside the target cell by microprojectile bombardment, right? Or through particle bombardment. So that's why it is known as ballistic particle delivery system. And in this process, by coating particles of a heavy metal with a gene of interest and firing these microprojectiles into cell using mechanical forces, an integration of desired genetic information can be induced into the cell. So when these microprojectile enters inside the cell, it goes to the nucleus, and in the nucleus, these DNA separates from the gold particle, and it integrates into the genome of the plant cell, right? And after its integration to the genome of the plant cell, it shows its application. So by this way, you can raise or you can form a transgenic line very easily, right? Transgenic lines of plants can be developed by this method very easily or very comfortably. So this is all about particle bombardment method of gene transfer. This is one type of physical method of gene transfer. Next physical method of gene transfer is micro injection. So in micro injection, what we generally do, we generally transfer or insert our gene of interest inside the nucleus or other intracellular spaces inside the cell by using glass micropipette of around 0.5 to 10 micrometer diameter, right? And the main advantage of this method is that it is more precise. It is one of the more precise gene delivery method. So you can easily see that through this process, you can directly inject your gene of interest into the nucleus of the cell or into the other intercellular spaces like mitochondria or chloroplast. But with some advantage, it also has few disadvantages. And what are those disadvantages? That it through this method you can damage your cell, right? And it is less efficient, means only one cell at one time can be transfected. So that's why it is less efficient method of gene transfer. Next important physical method of gene transfer is macro injection. So what we generally do in this method, we generally transfer our gene of interest by using injection of diameter greater than 10 to 100 micrometer, right? And in this method we generally transfer the recombinant DNA to serial plants that show inability to regenerate and develop into whole plants from culture cell. And one very important thing about this gene transfer method is that in this technique we don't inject DNA inside the cell, but we inject beside floral bud and inflorescence. So in this method we generally inject DNA at the base of the inflorescence here, right? And it can also be used in transferring the recombinant DNA to serial plants that show inability to regenerate and develop into whole plant from culture cell. So in this method can also be used in transforming the plants in transforming the plant which are generally grown in tissue culture medium, right? So this is the main advantage of this method of gene transfer, that is macro injection. Next important physical method of gene transfer is sonopuration. So as the name suggests, that in this method we generally use sound wave to transfer our gene of interest into the target cell. So what kind of sound wave generally used? Those sound waves are ultrasound waves, right? So what these ultrasound waves generally do? It generally disturbs the integrity of the plasma membrane. So when the integrity of plasma membrane disturbs, small pores generates across the plasma membrane, and from that pore the exogenous or foreign DNA enters inside the cell, and when it enters into the cytoplasm it undergoes into the nucleus, and the nucleus it integrates with the genome and shows its application. So by this way, through sonopuration, the foreign DNA enters inside the cells. So the main disadvantage of this process is that by the application of ultrasound, many cell can be damaged, right? So it can affect in the efficiency of the transformation of the cell with foreign DNA. Now I would like to talk about different chemical method of the gene transfer. So most important chemical method of the gene transfer is CaCl2 mediated gene transfer, and it's also known as bacterial transformation. And this is a method of introducing foreign DNA into the bacterial cell, that is E. coli cell, right? So what we generally do in this process, the first step is that first we make a chemically competent cell by applying the bacterial cell with, or by inoculating the bacterial cell with CaCl2 solution. So in this case, what happened? CaCl2 breaks into Ca2 plus ion and Cl minus ion, right? And this Ca2 plus ion, when comes in contact with the plasma membrane, it generally disturbs or it generally changes the permeability of bacterial cell wall, right? And that generally helps in the binding of plasmid DNA to bacterial cell lipopolysaccharide, which is generally present in the surface of the plasma membrane, right? So what CaCl2 generally do? CaCl2 generally helps in the, or you can say what Ca2 plus ion generally do, which is generally present all around the plasma membrane, it generally helps in attaching or connecting the foreign DNA or plasmid across the plasma membrane. And in the next step, when we apply heat shock to this competent cell, small pores develop all across the plasma membrane, and from that small pore, the foreign DNA enters inside the cell, and as a result of that, this transformed cell forms, right? So this method is very popular method for transforming the bacterial cell with foreign DNA, and this is very efficient method, right? And why this is efficient method? Because in this method you can transform one cell per thousand cell, right? So that's why this is more efficient method of introducing the foreign DNA inside the cell, because its transformation frequency is more in comparison to other method of gene transfer. Next chemical method of gene transfer is lipofection, or you can say liposome mediated gene transfer. In this process, what we generally do, first we generally use liposome, which is positively charged lipid molecules, and these positively charged lipid molecule interact with negatively charged foreign DNA and form lipid DNA complex that is known as lipoflex. And these lipoflex generally enters inside the cell by the process of endocytosis in the form of and forms endosome, right? And when these endosomes disintegrates, these foreign DNA comes out from these endosomes and it enters into the nucleus where it integrates with the genome and shows its application. So by this way, through liposome-mediated gene transfer, foreign DNA enters inside the target cell. So main advantage is that its transfection efficiency is quite high, and it works in a wide variety of eukaryotic cell, and it is easy to perform. So this is all about liposome-mediated gene transfer. Now the next chemical method is DEAE, that is diethyl aminoethyl dextran-mediated gene transfer. So dextran is the carbohydrate, and in this method what generally we do, first we prepare a cationic polymer, that is, and that polymer generally forms between DEAE dextran and DNA, right? And that cationic polymer generally enters inside the cell by the process of endocytosis. Again, this is the endosome, and when this endosome disintegrates, this foreign DNA comes out from this endosome and it enters into the nucleus, and in the nucleus it integrates into the genome, and again it shows its application. So by this way, through DEAED, we generally transfer our foreign DNA inside the target cell. So nucleic acid DEAE dextran complex are formed via electrostatic interaction between the polymer and phosphate backbone of the nucleic acid, and it is not so efficient method of the gene transfer, right? Now the next chemical method of gene transfer is PEG, or polyethylene glycol mediated gene transfer. So again, here polyethylene glycol make complex with calcium ion, or calcium divalent ion of calcium, and that calcium ion comes from here CaCl2 is given, but in the place of CaCl2 we generally use calcium nitrate. So just change it, just replace CaCl2 with calcium nitrate, and that PEG calcium ion complex generally change when it comes in contact with the plasma membrane. It generally disturbs the permeability, or you can say change the permeability of this plasma membrane, and as a result of that, pore forms all across the plasma membrane, and from that pore, foreign DNA enters inside the cell. Again, it goes to the nucleus, and in nucleus, it integrates with the genome and shows its application. So, PEG and divalent cation generally destabilizes the plasma membrane and pore forms in plasma membrane through which naked DNA enters inside the cell. So, it is very successful method for the plant transformation, and it is also useful in protoplast fusion. So, here protoplast is the plant cell which are generally devoid of cell wall, and that protoplast fusion generally helps in somatic hybridization. Here somatic hybridization is the formation of hybrid cell by the fusion of the cell protoplast of two different plant species, right? So about somatic hybridization we will discuss in the next class. So this method is also very popular method for inserting the foreign DNA inside the target cell, especially plant cell.